Hi everyone and welcome back. And here we are going to do one more exercise, and this time it is for Node.js. We have already done two exercises for React, one exercise for Angular, and this one we are doing for the Node.js. And now I hope if you have watched my previous videos, now you already understood what kind of problem statement there are and how to solve it. You already have a problem statement, you have a GitHub link, you need to clone it, you have to write code, you have to write the logic, and you have to get all the test case passing, and you have to push the code to the Heroku or to this HackerRank remote URL. Okay, let's see this question. This is for Node.js, and we have to work on middleware in Node.js. Okay, that is fine. This interview is for JavaScript full stack, so you should be good at Node.js or a front end, either React or Angular. Okay, so complete the middleware.js module. This module default export is an express.js module function. As I already talked about, most of the code is already written. You have to write your custom logic because it's not about writing the full application. It is just writing about the basic logic of the application and get your test case passing by satisfying all these conditions which this is asking for. Okay, now let's just go through this. Okay, the scope of the route is passed to the middleware as a string format, scope name and action name. Okay, example blah blah blah. Okay, so this route scope mapping is defined in the roles.txt. okay, here we have something like roles is admin, and scope is it can perform these tasks, another role, and it can perform these tasks. Okay, that is fine. So if your role is admin, you can do these two tasks, get by id and create. Okay, going back to the readme. Okay, so the role is a property which has to match with x role header, so you will be sending something in the x role header. If your role is admin, then you should be able to do these two tasks only. Okay, if your role is something else, then you should be able to do those tasks. So from what I understanding is, if your role is admin, you can do this. If your role is customer, then only you can do this get by id. If your role is customer, then you can't do create. Okay, so that we need to look into. Okay, now scope is an object containing key value pair, scope name in the system. If passed scope name does not match with any of the keys defined in the object, then you should return 403 forbidden. Okay, the role passed in the X role header, 403 if that is not available. If the role has access to the role, then just call the next function in the middleware. Complete the task.js module to include all the routes. Okay, cool. So the objective is we just need to check that user has access to this particular task or not. If in X API, if you are passing role customer and you are trying to access create, then you should not be able to do that. If your role is X role is admin, then you should be able to do both the things. Okay, so here is middleware.js and it's pretty much empty. Our objective is for every request, we have to read roles.txt and we have to check what is the role we are getting in the header. If we are getting it, then we have to check what kind of request you are looking for. Okay, if you're not authorized for that request, then we should be returning 403. So here you can see our controller or route. Okay, here we are calling, okay, this is middleware, right? In the middleware you can see we are passing an argument, tasks.create. So task is a scope and this is one action. Okay, so if you just check the roles.txt and put it in the controller, we should be able to understand it. So this is the task array is representing this. Get by id should match with one of these array if role is admin. If your role is customer, you should be able to get by id because it is there, but you should not be able to do create because create is not available in the scope of a role customer. Okay, so I mean we got the problem statement. This is how we need to do, and we need to get this string tasks.getByID, it contains scope and the action name. Okay, and we are writing middleware. So in this middleware, let's complete this. So here we already are passing scope, right? So scope contains two things, right? We can actually split a scope name by dot, and we can get both the values like a scope and action. Okay, first of all, let's get the header value const role, which we are going to get from request dot headers, and we are passing x role. Now we just need to check if do we really have this role defined. If not, then we can just return response.json, sorry, response.status 403, and don't worry about response because it's not explicitly specified. You will just send an empty JSON object or something else. If role is there, then what we need to do, we need to get the file content. So fs.readfile, this method we can use, and we can import fs. Okay, and we are using fs.readfile, which is comes with callback. We have roles file, and we are reading with the UTF-8. This we always specify, and here we are getting either error or we will get data. Okay. If we got data, that means we know we got what we need. Here you can just do the error first callback check. If there is an error, then you can just say response dot status for now, just return 403. fs.readfile, okay, should be capital. If we got data, now we need to get our values, which is local scope and our action from the scope we got is in the middleware scope.split based on. So these are separated with the dot. So this value we are going to get from the controller. Sorry, this controller. So we will get tasks in the local scope, and action is create. Now we can create a mapper, and we can do json.parse the data which we received from the file. This is the data because we are reading it from the file, so we just need to parse it. Now we can just do const is allowed. Here we are checking if you are allowed for that or not, so we can actually create a separate function because we are going to do a lot of checks here. And if is allowed is comes out as a true, then we can do simply like next, else we can just say okay, you're not allowed, response dot status, which is 403 dot json empty object, don't need to worry about it. Now check role is a function which we need to write in this file, function check role. It should take some argument. The argument can be okay, your mapper object, your local scope, and your action. It will just check if you are really allowed to do this or not. Okay, this should return some value. We will take care of this. So we are passing three argument and the role of user that we forgot, the current role of a logged in user. Okay, so that's it. Now here we got this as an array, right? This is now we got this as an array after json dot parse. Now we need to just do a map, need to check if the current role which is passed is admin. then we need to check if the scope is matching or the action is matching. So rest all is just a JavaScript logic we have to write. So for let I of mapper, we are running a for of loop, and here we are checking if the role which you just passed in the function, that is same as I dot role. That is true, means we got the correct role, and now we have to check the validations for it. We will get the scope from the iteration. I'm talking about this scope. Let's put it there so we can understand it. I'm talking about this scope array. Now we got the scope object. Okay, now what we will do is here we can run a condition from the scopes. Okay, it is scopes, not scope. In the scopes, if we have a local scopes, local scope is our tasks, right? And this is a task. If this is there, then we need to check scopes of local scope dot includes. This is an array. If this includes this particular action which we are passing, right? Now we are checking if create or get by id is there in the tasks array or not. If this is there, return it, otherwise return false. For rest all the other things return false. If you are passing a incorrect role, if you are able to return true, then that is fine, otherwise return false. So this function we have written. Now if you run npm run test, we should be able to pass all the test cases. So this is the logic which that HackerRank assignment is looking for. You should be able to write middleware and all on all the possible use cases. If the X role, X API role is not there, you should return 403. If you are not able to get the proper match for the scope and actions, you should return 403, right? There should be a test cases associated with this. These are written in the chai. Okay, like you can see app.get response 403, 403, 403, 200. If you are passing the correct role, here we can see that in the headers we are passing admin, then it should be 201. Here we are passing task customer. For create, then it should be 403, right? So these test cases should pass in that case. Okay, that's all we have in this video. I hope now you got understanding how to write logic, how to actually submit the test cases and submit it to HackerRank remote link. Okay, this because in most of the interviews they will always give you this kind of assignment on the HackerRank. There will be a Node.js question, React, Angular. If you are able to do it, then they will ask you for the second rounds and all these things. Okay, I just know all those things. That's why I put these questions to help developers, because sometimes what happens is people know everything, but after looking at these questions, they get scared or they are not able to concentrate much because there is a very big assignment. They will think about this, okay, a lot of requirement and all these things, but these are very simple. You just need to focus, you just need to read the readme file properly and get your task done. Okay, thanks everyone. I hope these videos will help you.